This SciShow video is supported by Ground News, a website and app that lets you compare how major events are being covered so you can see more sides of more stories. You can go to ground.news/SciShow or click the link in the description to get 30% off the Vantage Level subscription. According to research, around 80% of all patients diagnosed with autoimmune diseases are women. Given that women's needs in healthcare have historically been underserved or flat out ignored, it's practically a miracle that we've even managed to pick up on this disparity. And it's very real. Over the years, a lot of explanations have been proposed, but scientists still haven't settled on a definitive one. Emerging evidence is pointing towards a surprising sleeper option, and it's a molecule that prevents your chromosomes from poisoning you. Let me explain. So autoimmune disorders occur when your immune system sees its own healthy cells as a threat and starts to attack them. More than 80 autoimmune disorders have been identified, and basically all of them occur disproportionately in women. Well, sort of. Wait for it. For example, lupus is one of the most common autoimmune disorders, and it has a 9-to-1 female-to-male bias. In the far less common Hashimoto's thyroiditis, 95% of patients are female. But there's a twist to this, and it might be the key to understanding this whole thing. So see, autoimmune diseases actually don't disproportionately affect women, but very specifically, it's people with two or more X chromosomes. Generally, people are born with 23 pairs of chromosomes. There's 22 pairs of non-sex chromosomes, or autosomes, and then one pair of sex chromosomes, so XX or XY. People with Klinefelter syndrome have an extra X chromosome, making them XXY, and they may develop some typically masculine and feminine traits. People with trisomy X have 3 X chromosomes, and they develop just the typically feminine traits. And folks in both of these groups are more likely to have certain autoimmune disorders. It's also possible to have one X chromosome and that's it, and that's called Turner syndrome. And these individuals are less likely to develop autoimmune disorders even though they also develop some typically feminine traits. This gave scientists a pretty big clue that maybe it was the dosage of chromosome X that was responsible for this increased susceptibility to autoimmune disorders. So dosage is an odd choice of words in this case, but it just refers to how much output you're getting from any given genes, or chromosomeful of genes, as it were. To understand why this matters, you only need to know that duplications of most autosomes are fatal, with the only real exception being 3 copies of number 21. So it follows that for genes on your autosomes, the typical dosage is 2, one from each of your parents. For most genes, the copy on both chromosomes needs to be expressed for normal functioning. But it kind of has to work differently for sex chromosomes, since people with XY chromosomes inherited only one copy of X. Y is much smaller than X. While most autosomes have matching sets of genes, most of the genes on X don't have a partner. So we've evolved to only need one copy of our X genes, but that creates a new problem. Now XX people have one too many. Fortunately, we've developed a way to keep that extra X in check, so no extra genes are expressed. It's called X inactivation. And it means that in every single cell, one X, or two X's in XXX individuals, is selected to be locked down. The X chromosome produces a very large RNA molecule called EXIST. EXIST recruits 81 protein partners to make a huge complex that wraps itself around that extra X and silences it. It does this by making structural changes to the X chromosome, as well as through epigenetic modifications which help regulate which genes get expressed more or less. Some scientists have proposed that leaky or inadequate X inactivation could be the problem. The X chromosome has the largest number of immune-related genes in the entire genome. Some of these genes have been found to sneak around EXIST suppression. Excessive expression of X-linked genes is often seen in people with lupus who have XX chromosomes but not XY. Extra X-linked genes may be even more of an issue if they're running amok in the very cells that turn against you, immune cells. A 2020 paper reported that female mice with lupus-like disease had reduced EXIST signals in a subset of immune cells, and that these cells had too many copies of genes from the X chromosome being expressed. Some of these upregulated genes had been implicated in autoimmunity before, although exactly how this might lead to autoimmune disorders still needs further investigation. So that makes faulty X inactivation an important line of inquiry for scientists looking into these autoimmune disorders. But one research group has made a provocative suggestion. The cause isn't faulty X inactivation, but the very process itself. As reported in a 2024 paper, they made a male mouse model that could express EXIST, even though it would normally only be found in females. These mouse models also mimic the symptoms of lupus, although it had to be induced by the researchers. And when they did so, the severity of the disease was much worse in male mice with EXIST. They also showed that many autoimmune patients have antibodies for EXIST and its friends. The explanation they proposed is basically this. EXIST is a huge molecule with lots of identical sites for antibodies to potentially recognize. When cells die, they explode and release EXIST out into into the bloodstream, where they'd have ample opportunity to be spotted by the immune system and for antibodies to bind. The authors reasoned that, under the right conditions, all of this self-stickiness would lead to a cascade of immune autoreactivity. And that doesn't mean Exist causes autoimmune diseases all by itself. Individuals with XY chromosomes who don't make Exist still sometimes get autoimmune diseases. Furthermore, twin studies show that for some autoimmune disorders, like lupus, as few as 40% of identical twins will both develop the disease, meaning that genetics can't be the only factor. Environmental triggers, like components of your diet, an imbalance of gut microbes, and infections, they probably also come into play along with genes. However, the 2024 study is still a big step forward in understanding an important aspect of how autoimmune diseases work. And this research has implications for diagnostics too. If patients have antibodies to Exist, they'd be pretty easy to screen for, and even better if they have those antibodies before showing symptoms of disease. And if so, that's a great recipe for early detection. There's still a lot of work to do, but after hundreds of years of these diseases going understudied, it's exciting that we're finally exploring these potential explanations. Thanks to Ground News for supporting this SciShow video. Keeping up with the latest health news can be tough with all the different narratives out there, and it takes some serious fact-checking to feel confident about what we're sharing. And that's where Ground News comes in. Ground News is a startup that was founded in 2018 by Harlene Kaur, a former NASA engineer. This platform brings together news from around the world, giving folks like you and me the tools to approach information with a critical eye. You can use their app and website to explore what's happening in the health industry and discover what stories you might be missing. For example, this article is about how lupus and other autoimmune diseases strike far more women than men. And if you'd like to do more research, you'll have quick access to over 60 sources. These stories come from politically centered publications, highlighting a significant blind spot for individuals who exclusively rely on either left or right leaning sources. And 91% of these sources, which is a vast majority, are highly factual, providing us with reliable information. Another feature with Ground is that you can filter by high factuality and also by location, so you can read into international sources to get insight into different perspectives. And also, you can track your habits with My News Bias and view factuality ratings to know what you're reading is accurate. Thanks to Ground News for supporting this SciShow video. You can check them out by visiting ground.news/SciShow or clicking the link in our description below to get 40% off unlimited access with their Vantage plan. Thanks for watching SciShow.